The three aerospace primes, Boeing, Lockheed Martin, and Northrop Grumman, could be expected to compete to build the manned sixth-generation fighter that will serve as the foundation of the NGAD family of systems. Industry partners already involved with the NGAD program is the USAF awarded General Electric Aviation, Pratt and Whitney, Boeing, Lockheed Martin, and Northrop Grumman, each an indefinite-delivery, indefinite-quantity contract for the prototyping phase of the Next Generation Adaptive Propulsion Program. The Air Force wants drones to cost no more than half as much as an F-35, making the most expensive CCAS around $40 million. However, Kendall said he would like to spend a factor less than that because some drones will be lost in combat. It would be far easier for the USAF to lose unmanned attritable aircraft than expensive, high-end fighter jets. The final cost will depend on the mission equipment the service decides to install in the drones. Fielding CCAS with various mission packages has advantages, and options include adding weaponry, sensors, electronic warfare systems, or other effects. The NGAD manned aircraft is expected to cost hundreds of millions of dollars to the U.S. Air Force, surpassing the expensive fifth-generation F-35 aircraft. Therefore, the emphasis on low-cost, uncrewed aircraft that support the expensive fighter jet is not misplaced. The Air Force must take steps to start learning how to employ combat drones alongside fighter aircraft as it develops CCAS. This includes knowing how to maintain such drones, how to organize a unit's personnel, and how unmanned operations would be integrated into battle management. NGAD vision includes over 5 drones flying alongside a combat aircraft and performing missions such as strike, surveillance, and electronic warfare, or serving as decoys to draw fire, with few instructions from a human pilot. NGAD revealed that the US was looking to cooperate with Australia on unmanned platforms, including the Boeing MQ-28 Ghost Bat Drivone. The MQ-28 is the first military aircraft produced by Australia in nearly 50 years. Incidentally, one of the drones is now in the United States, with Boeing eyeing an opportunity to pitch it to the service as part of future advanced drone initiatives. Contracts to construct autonomous aircraft supporting the Skyborg program in 2020 had been awarded to Boeing, General Atomics, and Kratos. Boeing is no longer part of the Skyborg program, but would undoubtedly want to plug in the CCA program for the Next Gen Air Dominance program. Overall, it is too soon to predict how the Air Force will carry out its CCA objectives, but its future manned-unmanned teaming vision is becoming more evident. It could become a reality by 2030, when the NGAD manned aircraft is expected to enter service.